Amanda Webb.
Yes.
From Spider Working.
Yeah.
I like what you did there.
Very cool.
So for anyone that's watching, how did you come up with the name?
When I started the digital marketing business, I was doing something else beforehand. I decided I needed to get a .com, and my name's Web, which is suitable. So I started with WebNet, which, like you said, worst name ever.
Well, I didn't use those words, but
well, you didn't say it on camera, thank God.
So I looked for .com. I couldn't get that .com because someone boring already had it. And okay. Then I searched. I spent all night in Black Knight, which is the hosting company, going through trying to find a .com. Like literally all night. It was daylight was coming when I finally found spiderworking.com was available, because I think it's important. I didn't want to just be, I'm based in Ireland, I didn't want to limit my audience to Ireland, which I think you might do if you went got a .ie. So that's where it came from.
Good call. Yeah, probably.
Hundreds of names I went through before I got it.
So what do you do?
I help small businesses with their digital marketing, so social media, email marketing, blogging specifically. I really like with that content creation. Help them build strategies. I also do training as well.
How are we doing?
You seem to be doing okay.
All right.
You seem to be doing
okay. Going in the right direction.
Solid 4 out of 10.
Yeah. Solid 4, yeah. Plus 6.
But this is
plus you're doing Snapchat, aren't you? Which I don't do so much. Or are you not doing Snapchat so much? I'm interviewing you now.
Do you know what? We were doing, this is interesting, we were doing Snapchat. But it's really hard to build an audience at it. And that's not kind of us giving up on it. But since Instagram launched, stories,
exactly,
it's a lot easier, isn't it?
Because you already have an audience. Facebook launched theirs. Now even WhatsApp coming out with something.
I know. Yeah.
Like, they're all coming out with something. So it's really like, I know, like, even our good friend Gary Vee says you need to be on everything.
It's impossible.
Yeah.
You can't be Gary Vee. Yeah. Gary Vee is like a crazy man. Like, yeah, he's brilliant. He's loved, but you can't be him. You just can't be him. Yeah, I gave up on Snapchat.
People stop comparing themselves to Gary Vee because he doesn't sleep. Yeah. But
we're more kind of Instagram story now at the moment, aren't
we? Because we just had an audience there already and we're building on that with the stories. On Snapchat, it was just like, 40 people who are all our friends seeing it. Like, that's what Facebook's for.
We still love you, friends.
Yeah, sorry, watching. Deep friends. You know. But it's interesting that people get confused about what should I do, what should I concentrate on. And I would say do try everything, but for 1 month.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and whatever
really
works.
Really go hard at it for a month, tire yourself out, and then look and go, this didn't work, but these four worked, I'm going to concentrate on these. Because you're already different audience. We can't tell somebody to concentrate on Snapchat or Instagram stories. Maybe their audience isn't.
What do you think?
I think it's down to the business. There's a couple of things. There's one, your audience, obviously. Where are your audience?
Yeah.
So I was messing with Snapchat because it was fun. Mm. My audience really weren't on it, or if they were, they were only dabbling in it. I was going to reach them better somewhere else.
Exactly.
And then there's you. So another reason I don't do Snapchat, and I don't do many Instagram stories, I do them. I might do one from today because it's easy to do today, is because it's so time consuming. It's like you can't just do one photo. Like I limit myself to 2 photos on Instagram a day. So I can do 2 photos from here, great. If I do a story, I need 5 or 10 in order to make it interesting. And I got excited about Facebook stories. There's all my friends who I've never seen creating them before, and they're just putting one picture up. Why wouldn't you just do that in your Facebook feed?
So I think it's not a story, it's a photo.
Yeah.
You know, if you need to create, you need to document your day. That's the idea behind it. So people are putting up a picture of a cup of coffee in the morning and that's it. That's not a story.
Yeah.
I remember just going back to your point there about it depends on where your audience are. Like the whole thing, I remember doing a digital course and it was a class full of people and there was a guy there and everyone's like, are you on Facebook? And he's kind of like, no, I'm not. And he's like, what do you mean you're not? But there's a billion people on Facebook, if not more, right? And he goes, I don't care if there's a billion people on Facebook. Are my audience on Facebook? Are my potential customers on Facebook? And I was like, what do you do? Well, I own an estate agent and I sell houses down the country here. And then people were kind of, okay, maybe your audience aren't on Facebook and the billion that we're all talking about aren't that. But it is. Know your audience, know what they're using.
Yeah.
And target them that way.
Yeah, definitely, without a doubt. So what do you find small to medium businesses come up against? What's the hardest thing about digital marketing for them? Is it finding the right platform? Is it executing? Because I know I want to do video or I want to do cool photos and want to do whatever, and then they go, great, how? That's the thing.
I think there's time, because everyone's, that's the biggest question, how do you find time for all that? And I think people assume, because this is what I do, that I'm just like here at the Sage Summit, that is what I'm doing all day long, creating content. I love that. But most of the time, I'm against the same time restrictions as everyone else. Yeah. I have to try and create it. So time, so that's one thing, is how you can be more productive, how you can create stuff. And then, yeah, what to post. Because the mistake I made when I first started doing it, and loads of businesses make, is they kind of go, oh, I have to put something on Facebook today. And then they start thinking about what they're going to put on Facebook. Mm. And that's why kind of putting strategies and content plans in place, it just makes it a lot more streamlined. It solves the what should you do, and it solves the how much time it's going to take as well.
Yeah. A lot of the time, it's also just start. Just do something. Yeah. See how you get on. See what works for you.
And people can get really enthusiastic about a network like Facebook, and suddenly they're posting 10 times a day for like a week and a half, and then they stop. And that's really bad as well, because, you know, people have started to expect seeing things. Once they had too much content, now they've got no content. Then they'll have another spurt in a month's time. Yeah. You really need to come up with some sort of plan to be consistent. Yeah.
We were guilty of that with Snapchat. We would go through a phase, and 2 or 3 days on Snapchat would be fun. Our Snapchat story was great today. And then we'd stop for like two or 3 weeks and start again. And now we're kind of gone to then Instagram launch stories.
We had so much going on at the time as well. Like we were vlogging, we were getting everything on Snapchat, we were getting photos, we were doing interviews. There was a lot going on.
Yeah, of course. So it's just about trying to juggle some stuff, but really concentrate on what matters. What's the you're based in Ireland.
Yeah.
What's the Irish market like for digital marketing and how things are progressing?
It's huge. In fact, what's really interesting about Ireland, what excites me, is I'm a big fan of Twitter, and I know Twitter's
Love it.
And so many people are like losing faith in Twitter, but in Ireland it is still the second most active users in Ireland, above, well, pretty similar to Instagram now, and LinkedIn over there. So there's still a lot of people in Ireland using Twitter, which is great because I love it, so I don't have to persuade people.
I don't want
people
it to
much.
Go away either.
No, and like I swear I should work for Twitter. They should pay me because I'm going around going, you've got to use Twitter, you've got to use Twitter. And I think we are very active. I don't know why, because it's such a small country and we can actually just go and see each other very easily. But there's so many people using it, and I think there's a lot of small businesses. There's a lot of micro businesses who I don't really work with. It's slightly bigger than that, but they are all embracing it. And I think there's enough kind of ambassadors out there that it's spread like wildfire. So I think we're very, very active.
Yeah, well, that's where we got our start, was Twitter in Ireland.
Mm-hmm.
And it was our first ever tweet we put up, got 113 retweets, and I don't know how many comments.
Yeah.
It was something new and different, but the Irish community jumped all over it on Twitter, which was so cool. Again, it spread like wildfire throughout the Twitter entrepreneur community in Dublin, and not even Dublin, throughout the whole of Ireland.
Yeah.
So it's really cool. But we never let anyone out of the van without giving one piece of advice to entrepreneurs watching. In your case, around social media and strategy and marketing. So what one piece of advice would you give?
It's all about the customer, everything. The more I do, the more I get into this, the more marketing I learn, the more stuff I run. It is knowing your customer, like not just knowing them, but actually really, really knowing them, and always thinking about, is what I'm doing now going to give them value? Is that going to give them value?
Yeah.
Whether it's your content marketing or whether it's your customer service, you know, it should be absolutely the customers at the center, because why are you doing it otherwise?
Exactly.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, of course.
Very cool. That's a great piece of advice.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you
for getting in the startup, fan. Really appreciate your time.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.